Hi everyone, so this welcome to the WebDriver tutorial, and this is going to be a day 31. In the previous tutorial we actually created simple framework. You know, we actually started with a framework. I created a test class. Let's go back here. So there is a base test. Base test is acting like a parent class for all the test classes, and in SRC test Java we have sample test class, and this sample test is extending base test. So before method, after method, and the driver instance is automatically coming from the base test. We also learn why we made the driver method, driver object private, and we wrote another protected method that is going to return the driver object, so that we can utilize the driver method which returns the object, you know, here. So this is similar like driver.get and the URL. Before method, after method is automatically coming from the base test. So you don't need to worry about writing code. That will open your browser and close your browser for every test case. Perfect. So let's give a run once and see the test execution. So this is very simple test case. Just searching Vikas Tange text into Google page, and after searching, you know, I'm just verifying whether that page URL is containing https://google.co.in/search. So the test case got passed. So this is what that test case is doing. But now what I want is, I want to have next thing to be implemented in the framework. So I'm talking about the page objects here. You know, just now what we wrote is, we wrote a test method. That method is having complete code to execute. So, sir, you know, typing Vikas Tange, opening page, typing Vikas Tange, searching a text and verifying the URL. Now, what I want is, I want to implement page object model in the framework. So, let me tell you what is page object model. Page object model, I'm not talking about pom.xml, okay? Don't get confused with page object model and the pom.xml. See, pom.xml is coming from a Maven. I'm not talking about the Maven's feature. I'm talking about page object model, that is a design pattern actually for designing your you know, page objects. So what is the concept of page object model? The concept is, as I explained earlier, for every physical web page we will create a logical class. So let's say there is a login web page containing username, password, login button, clear button. So all these locator I will write into class login, and I will also write a method, let's say do login or something like that. So we create a logical class for each physical web page. So the example I already gave, one is a login, but let's do it practically, you know, more or just implement in a practice. So coming back to this test, you know, what I will do is, I will create a new test class, or let's go and modify the same test. So here I'm going to write code as without page object model. This is how the code will look like without page object model. Let's say I want to write a test case with a page object model. So I'm giving test case number 2. So with page object model is what I want. So if you are using a page object model, then I don't need this code. So I'm just simply deleting it, okay? Except that last assertion, I will require that last assertion, but not in this way. I will again modify that. So this test case, you know, I want to implement page object model for this test case. So let's see how we do it. So actually, you know, let's say I want to open a Google home page, you know. So for this web page, I need to have a class. So I'm saying Google home page class. So going here, you know, in the SRC test Java, creating a class. The class name is Google home page. Guys, if you want a package, you know, it is always good to give some package name. So I'm giving com.vikas. Or let's say learning. This is my package name. Okay, and in that package I want a page package. So I'm saying page package. So that page package is going to contain all the pages. So Google homepage is a part of page package. Let's say finish. All right, so I have a Google homepage package. So as I said, you know, classes contain two things. One is a data member, or also known as fields. Okay, and second is the methods. So, you know, see, I want this logical class to represent my physical web page. So this on this web page, I will be performing actions on the text box, on this login search button. So let's inspect it. So this is the input, okay? Search for ID is equal to or name equal to. Actually, it has name equal to Q. Okay, I can see that. Fine. So do you see that name equal to Q? So coming back here, guys, I'm following one annotations. You know, this annotation is find by. Okay, find by. This is coming from Selenium. Brackets and then say name is equal to Q. And then declare the web element. So web element is my data member. So I will say txt query to query box, I will say. Alright. So this is my data member, you know. @findby, this is annotation. Don't get confused between the TestNG's annotation. @findby is not coming from TestNG, it is coming from Selenium. As you can see that package name, see, org.openqa.selenium. And find by is something, you know, there we write a locator that how to locate the element. So I'm saying by name is equal to Q, and this is the web element, you know, where the element will be stored. So I have the data member. Similarly, I will do it for the Google search button. Okay, it is having button name equal to BT and K. Just confirm once that this is unique. So I'm saying write CSS selector and it says unique, one of one matching. So it is unique. So I will say @findby. Again, I have to find by name. So, you know, if you say control space, you will get all the 8 locator option. You can write any locator which you want. So I'm saying the name locator. BTN, I think K, BTN K. Am I right? Yeah, I'm right. So web element, the name I will give to that object is BTN Google search. Okay, as I said, classes are two things. One is the data member. I'm done with my data member. Now I have to perform method. So on Google homepage, you know, you will write all the methods that you perform on a Google homepage. So the most common and popular method is perform search, right? So I'm writing a method, public void, perform search. And there I'm writing, you know, in perform search, I'm just going to, this is my web element, you know, you don't have to call driver.find element. You already have that web element, so you don't need to find the element, okay? We already declared that web element here. So I'm saying web element dot send keys. Now what to type, right? I need to, that as an input. So I'm going to take that input from this method. So this method is parameterized. Text to search. Just pass it here. All right, so txt query box, you know, the web element which has to be found by name Q. On that web element, I want to say that send keys, and how I'm searching element? I'm searching element by, sorry, how I'm sending a keys? With the text to search. Next is button Google search dot click. You know, I want to perform click on that method, on that button search. All right. So this is my page class, guys, you know, and this class is going to represent the physical web page. This is the my physical web page, what you are seeing here. And this class is like logical representation of my physical web page. You write the all locator here, and you will also write all the elements that you perform on that web page. So on this web page, I'm searching a product, I'm searching something, I'm searching a query. So I just typed it and clicking OK, you know, clicking on that button. Now, coming back to the test case, you know, see, I just opened a page. Now what I want is, I want the object of Google home page, because right now my browser, now browser is having Google home page open. So next step is create object of Google home page. So how do we create object of Google home page? So I'm saying Google home page. Let's say home page is equal to new Google home page. Okay, simply I'm just creating object of the Google home page. This is very easy, but guys, let me tell you one thing. Even if the object is created, the elements are not initialized yet. Okay, always remember this. I just now created object of Google home page, but the default value, you know, I'm calling a default constructor, and by default this will have none, this will have null. So both data member will have null. You know what I want is, I want to initialize this web element as well. I want to initialize this web element also. So I'm saying next line, okay, initialize perfect. So how do we initialize the web element? So in Selenium we already have a class, a built-in class is there with the Selenium. The class name is Page Factory. So Page Factory, it is a class that helps us to create object of web pages. You know, it is like factory of pages. So I'm saying Page Factory dot init element, I want to init with driver, and then you have to pass which object you want to initialize. So I have that object, right, home page. And I'm just simply saying, okay, guys, you cannot use directly driver. You have to call driver method so that it will return the driver object, okay? This is our framework standard. So this line is going to initialize all the web elements which are there in that object. So internally, you know, Page Factory, it's a class. On that class, I'm calling a static method. And this static method internally calls driver.find element for each and every web page element. Okay, so driver.find element is internally called. You don't have to call yourself. Init element is the static method which is going to take care of all this thing. And finally, on that object, you know, just simply call do search. You know, just call the method that we just now wrote. So the method name is perform search, and there you can give any text that you want. So let's say I'm saying Vikas Thange. Perfect. Okay, guys, I don't want to close my browser, so I'm going to base test. There I wrote a code cleanup. I'm just going to comment after method. So this method is going to be there, but it will not be called automatically because it is not having after method annotation. So until and unless you're not calling this method, nothing is going to happen. I don't want to call this method because it was closing my browser. I don't want to close my browser also. Perfect. Let's come back here and see 1, 2, 3, and 4. The test case is now just a 4 lines. And the first line is opening a web page. Second line is creating object of Google homepage. Third line is initializing all the web elements which are present inside that Google homepage object. Okay, inside this homepage object. And next is, on the object, I'm just calling perform search method. So perform search method, what it does is, it basically send keys, you know, the text which I have passed to the method into the query box, and then it clicks on Google search button. So it is that simple. Let me run this test case and see the execution result. Okay, see, the search result has happened. The browser, oh, okay, there is another method which is getting executed. So I guess I should have selected that one specific method and then only run that one specific method, okay? All right, so I'm going to close it. Yeah, just forget about that. Oh, there is an exception. What is that? So test case 1 got passed, test case 2 got failed. I was expecting test case 2 got get pass, you know. So let me run test case 2 again, only test case 2, you know, just select test case 2 like this, right click and say run as test ng test. Oh, okay. See, there is a problem. Now, what is the problem? Come back here and see what is the problem. It says unknown error element input type Google search button. You know, I'm talking about that element with BT and K. And Selenium says is not clickable. You know, you cannot click on that button. The reason you can see that, right? After typing some result, that Google search buttons gets hidden under some element, you know. So see, this is the real element, but as soon as you type something, that button is getting hidden and another Google search button is shown. So let me inspect that new Google search button. Okay, it's having value as Google search, class is equal to LBS something. I can use this class is equal to LBS for locating that element, but again, you know, I don't want to make things complicated. So what I'm going to do is I will make easy choice. After typing the value, I will say submit in that text box. So submit is like calling the default action of a form. Okay. Just now I just simplified the existing test case. Okay, the result is there. Browser has not closed because we commented that after method, and you can see test case 2 got passed without any failure message. I hope you guys understood that how what is page object model and how to use it. Now let me tell you a few more details about the page factory. Page factory, it's a built-in class. If you want to see the more details, let me just open that here. Okay. Alright, so see, page init element method basically takes the driver object and again takes the object of page. And then there is a, you know, init element inside again which calls, and there is internally there are lots of coding, but this is all built in code, you know, you don't have to really go inside it. But internally, you know, somewhere it is calling driver.find element. So that is what it matters, you know. I hope you understood, but you know, on a high level, page factory, it's a class, I'm calling static method, and this method takes driver instance and which page object you want to initialize. So this is it. So init element method basically takes help of you know, all the annotations that we have written here. So for every web element we have at the rate find element, right? So init element method uses a Java reflection, it pulls out how to locate the element, and then it says find element by whichever choice that I have given, and it initializes the web element object. So this is how init element works.